Goedemorgen, good morning. How are you lovely people doing? I'm about to do something with my mom because we're gonna go cow hugging. Cow hugging, koeknuffelen in Dutch, is a thing here in the Netherlands. There are a lot of dairy farms. The people that have habited this part of the world have for a very long time raised cattle for dairy, for meat. I received hugging a cow as a gift for my 25th birthday. I have to be honest, I'm really excited to hug the cow because I think cows look really flippin' cute and I feel like hugging them is warm and lovely to do. I am aware that we are going to a dairy farm and that these cows are raised in a financial institution or a situation where their product is the end means of their existence. So I feel a little double about going. Obviously, I'm really grateful for receiving that gift because I really want to hug a cow, but the money is going to support a business which I don't longer choose to support since I am eating vegan. I am gonna take you along because I want to show you the world of the cow as well. And I made a list with questions. It's their business and it's their profession, and I bet they're really loving and caring for their animals. And how I see that just differs from how they see it. My mom is here now!
Good morning!
Good morning. By the way, my mom came in with a pie. She baked a vegan chocolate avocado-based cheesecake kind of dish. And it looks delicious.
Hoeveel wagen heeft de koe?
Ik had 4.
Ik dacht 3.
Het zijn er 4. Eerst is de pens, netmaag, boekmaag, lepmaag. Herkauwen.
Ja, dat is opnieuw het eten kauwen.
Ja, als we straks bij de koeien zijn, kun je het zien. De koe eet met zijn tong, gaat in grote brokken zijn pens in. Dan worden de bolletjes van ongeveer een half pond van gemaakt. Die gaan terug in zijn bek. Dan wordt het vermalen. Als hij daarmee klaar is, gaat het ene bolletje terug. Die zakt aan het begin van de pens door naar de netmaak, boekmaak, lepmaak. En ondertussen komt er weer een nieuw bolletje.
Ik had een plat gebit voor het malen.
Het heet een maalgebit. Bij een koe houdt dat in. Hij heeft aan de onderkant tanden kiezen. Boven heeft hij 2 of 3 versleten kiezen, maar hij heeft geen voortanden. Het kalfje wordt dan wel met tandjes en kiesjes geboren. En als ze 2, 2,5 jaar zijn, dan gaan ze wisselen.
Maar bij zitten.
Hallo.
Ja, precies. Altijd even van voren de bananen.
Hi. Hallo, baby. Wat schat. Hallo. Zo cute. Hoe oud is zij of hij?
Dit zijn 2 ei's. Die is nu een dag of 10.
Oh, 10 dagen. En wanneer is hij weggenomen bij zijn moeder?
Het hangt er een beetje vanaf wanneer ze geboren worden, zeg maar.
En hij is
ongeveer
dus
een halve dag tot 3/4 dag. Ja, hij gaat gewoon staan.
Nee, hij gaat er niet uit?
Dat moeten we voorkomen, hè?
Nee.
Oh. Precies, als je zo je hand ervoor houdt, dan wat je net deed. Ja, oh, precies zo. Zie je?
En dit is dus een mannetje.
Dit zijn 2 mannetjes.
Hij is 10 dagen oud, maar ja. Wordt dit een koe voor de vleesindustrie of voor het kalfsvlees of de kalfsvlees?
Oh, ik heb geen, hiervan gaat hij met 14 dagen, als hij 14 dagen oud is, weg. En wat het, meestal gaan ze naar opfokbedrijven.
Een opfokbedrijf?
Ja.
Oh, hij is een beetje druk.
Hoe noem je een mannetje of een vrouwtje kalm? Stier is voor mannetje en voor vrouwtje is een kuik. En dan met 1 jaar, 1,5 jaar is het een pink. En met 2, 2,5 jaar dan zijn het fazen. En daarna wordt het een melk.
Maar je kan niet heel goed bewegen nu.
Nee, dit is alleen voor de eerste 14 dagen.
En waarom moet die dan in zo'n hokje?
Nou, als je deze gelijk bij elkaar zet, dan gaan ze onder andere aan die naveltjes zitten te sabbelen.
Oh, ja.
Dan krijg je navelinfectie, navelbreuken. Vandaar dat ze dus wel met de koppen bij elkaar kunnen, maar dus niet met de naveltjes.
En hoeveel liter melk geeft de koe gemiddeld per dag? Het gemiddeld is ongeveer tussen de 25 en de 30.
Serieus?
Ja, als een koe net gekalfd heeft, dan kan hij 40, 50 liter per dag geven. Dus dat moet je dan wel delen door 2. Maar dat zakt natuurlijk ook weer af. En hoeveel liter water heeft hij dan voor nodig?
Ik dacht 10, maar dat is dan... Waarschijnlijk ook wel.
Ik zou er een 0 achter zetten.
100 liter water?
Ja. Wow. De eerste 2 dagen krijgen ze de fles met de biest. En kunnen ze goed uit de bakjes drinken, dan krijgen ze gewoon daar de melk in.
Oh ja.
En degene die dus blijven, die gaan dus met 14 dagen naar de groepshokken.
Ja. En die blijven, neem ik aan dat dat vrouwtjes zijn?
Ja.
Doet een extern bedrijf dat zeg maar hier kalfsvlees van maken? Of?
Ik weet dus niet waar deze naartoe gaan.
Oké.
Okay. We hebben 1 vast iemand die de kalfjes koopt.
Ja.
En die gaan gewoon naar de markt. En waar ze heen gaan, weet ik niet.
En vindt u dat niet lastig?
Nou, nee. Als je 100 kalfjes hebt en je hebt 50 stieren, daar hebben we niks aan.
Ja.
We hebben toevallig nu 2 kleine stiertjes, die zitten wel in de hokken. Die gaan we opfokken voor fokstier, voor dekstier.
Oh ja.
Dus die blijven wel. En voor de rest blijven de vrouwtjes.
Hey. Hallo. Ze worden eigenlijk al van jongs af aan getraind om dan uit de fles te drinken, want dan kunnen ze 2 liter drinken, wat voldoende is.
De biest geef je dus voornamelijk met de fles, omdat je dan zeker weet dat het erin
zit. Dat ze het binnenkrijgen.
Oh, okay.
Ja. En daarna moeten ze gewoon leren drinken uit bakje. Want als deze wel naar de jongvee gaan en ze zijn niet assertief genoeg om die melk op te drinken, daar moeten ze uit zo'n grote bak drinken.
Ja.
Nou, als ze dat niet kunnen, dan heeft de rest het al opgedronken.
They do stay with the same age.
Hij doet eigenlijk alles met kunstmatige inseminatie. Gewoon omdat je bij de koe uit kan zoeken welke stier erbij past. We hebben 1 koe die heeft een enorm groot uier, een valse eigen. En als je daar een stier op zet die een grote uier zou vererven, dan krijg je koeien met problemen omdat de uiers te groot worden. En dan heb je een stier, is heel leuk, maar dan heb je 1 stier. En daar moet je het dan mee doen. Kunstmatige inseminatie is gewoon het makkelijkste. Je kan het 100 stieren uitzoeken welke je hebben wil. Dan krijg je elke 3 maanden een nieuwe uitdraai met welke stieren er zijn, met alle kenmerken die er zijn. En daar kun je dan uitzoeken. Als er een koe geïnsemineerd moet worden, dan komen ze.
Best wel scherp dan ik dacht.
Ja, maar als een koe geen ruige tong zou hebben, dan krijgt hij zijn voedsel niet naar binnen.
Nee, dat is waar.
Want hij eet met zijn tong. Elke 4 weken onze ongesteldheid en de koe heeft hem elke 3 weken. 24 uur voordat hij tochtig wordt, of voordat hij ongesteld wordt, zeg maar, is hij tochtig. En dan kan hij bevrucht worden. Dat kun je soms zien aan het gedrag van de koeien. Maar ze hebben tegenwoordig een halsband met een activiteitenmeter.
Oh echt?
En dan kun je op de computer zien, als een koe normaal zit hij op 100, is hij echt goed tochtig, dan zie je dus een piek en dan weet je dus
grappig.
Dat je moet insemineren. Ik wil niet altijd zeggen dat het gelijk lukt. Het zou heel leuk wezen als het in 1 keer klaar is, maar dat is niet altijd zo. Als ze dus niederachtig zijn, dan krijgen ze gewoon wat bloedverlies. En dan moet je dus weer 3 weken wachten. Dan koe je gewoon 9 maanden. Omdat een koe natuurlijk elke 3 weken in principe geïnsemineerd kan worden, heb je dus ook het hele jaar door kalfjes. Niet zoals met schapen en zo in het voorjaar, maar gewoon het hele jaar door. Als we straks in de stal zijn, dan is een heel klein gedeelte is niet zwanger, omdat die net bevallen zijn.
Mm-hmm.
En de rest wordt allemaal begin tot half zwanger te zijn.
Oké. Okay.
cleaner the cow, the less flies the cow has. This is obviously very normal, but surprisingly, it doesn't smell like when you pet a dog. I like dogs a lot, but they do smell sometimes. You're really pretty, aren't you?
Alle koeien hebben in de linkerkant een klein rondje in plaats van zo'n grote flapper. En dat is voor deze machine. Hier krijgen de koetjes die net gekalfd hebben 30 dagen wat extra's. Dit zijn gedroogde appeltjes. En dit is uitgeperste mosterdzaadjes. Als je geen biest geeft, gaat het, die wordt steriel geboren. Dus die heeft helemaal geen antistof.
Nee.
Dus die heeft echt de biest nodig. Hoeft niet per se van de eigen moeder te zijn.
En hoe lang krijgt zo'n kalfje dan biest? De biest?
Minimaal 48 uur.
Oké. En na die 48 uur, wat krijgt het
dan? Dan krijg je gewoon koeienmelk.
And then I was home. I wanted to discuss the questions that I had thought of before I went to hug the cows. I'm really thankful that when I asked her whether or not I could film her and put her on YouTube, she was actually really open to that as well and to the questions. So really a really kind lady. Else has really shared information with me that, you know, I mean, I appreciate her for giving those answers to me. How do you get the sperm to impregnate the cows? They get the sperm from this company called the CRV. And they basically get a list of bulls and they can choose a bull that fits most with a certain cow. They actually freeze the sperm like the other company does, and the company that actually has the whole list of the different kinds of bulls, they also impregnate the cows themselves. So the farmers don't do that. They could, but they don't. And it's actually a lot more time saving to let the company do it. How many cows do you impregnate per season? The woman told me right away, there's not really seasons. Women get their period about every 4 weeks, and cows actually get their period every 3 weeks. So 24 hours before they get their period, they are more likely to receive. So therefore this cow will be inseminated. She said that they have 100 cows that produce milk, and right now they have 60 calves. Basically, once a calf is born, it'll take a little while for the body of the cow to get used to being impregnated again, so they don't want to impregnate the cow right away. Obviously it depends, the woman said, if the cow had a good birth experience or if it was a more difficult one. But then they usually wait 4 to 5 times of the cow producing milk, and then after that they can impregnate the cow again, if I understood that correctly at least. Does every cow get pregnant with this process, or do cows sometimes not get impregnated? And she said the first time about like 40% actually turns out to be impregnated. However, it differs per cow because some cows are more likely to get pregnant than others. How many calves do you expect every year? By theory, you could expect every cow to have a calf every year. But it doesn't always work out that way. But that's in theory what they expect. How many calves are male? So how many calves are bulls? And she said she currently has 2 bulls that she's keeping, which she will later on use for the sperm and like to impregnate the cows that they have. By the way, the reason she also said that she has an outside company is because she doesn't want the cows or the bulls to impregnate family members, like to not impregnate their daughters basically. It's about like 50-50 males and females, which makes total sense. She also said, which I thought was really interesting, one cow actually had twins, but usually when a cow has twins where it's one boy and one girl, the girl has more male cow DNA in her body, so therefore they're not as likely to produce milk as properly. So I asked her, do you usually let that calf go to like the slaughterhouse? But it depends on whether or not the cow produces the milk properly, because otherwise they'll just keep her. She also mentioned that before they had a cow with a little more tilted head and one blind eye, and that cow produced milk perfectly fine. Do you take care of the calf's meat yourself, or does an external company do this? And she said when a cow is a minimum of 14 days old, they're allowed to leave the property. And then an external company picks them up and they go to the market. I asked her if she knows where that is, but she just knows they go to the market. And that's actually the thing that I found more difficult, because we walked up, when we first did the tour, we walked up to a 10-year-old calf. Actually, there were two 10-year-old calves, I believe. And it's interesting to believe that 4 days from now, those bulls, because they were both bulls, are allowed to leave the property to become food. Like, that was kind of heart touching when I snuggled those cows at first. But you know, as long as people exist that want to eat meat, then this kind of industry will exist. After how many pregnancies is the calcium percentage too low? And she actually said that it's not really like that it's not because of the pregnancies. She said that, but I mean, I haven't done more research, but in one documentary, I believe it was Cowspiracy, and some other YouTube videos about like them going down on their like, I don't know, not being able to stand up because of the calcium deficiency. But according to her, it's not like that. But they do say they put extra vitamins and calcium into the food and they check it. For example, when a calf has been born, they can tell when a cow is not able to stand up right away. They have a calcium deficiency, and they have after the birth process, they give a shot with like a calcium boost. Do the cows that do not produce well enough go to the slaughterhouse? After how many years is this? She said yes, because cows that don't produce as well go to the slaughterhouse, but it's not dependent on age, but it has to do with the production of milk. Like, some cows can just produce milk better than others can. How much money do you earn per cow? And she said that's actually really hard to measure, because all the milk is going through the tubes and going into one big bin. The first 2.5 years, they don't make any money off of the cows, and then afterwards they want to make money as long as they can off of one cow. Also, one thing that was interesting, they save that milk into that container for 3 days, and then it gets picked up by another company, because their milk actually goes into making cheese. How do you take a calf away from its mom? Do you do this right away? So the calves, the first 48 hours, the calves live off of beast. And it depends on the birth and when that birth is, whether or not that calf gets that beast from the mother cow or in a different way. But usually the calf, like the 48 hours of beast, is not just with the mom. According to the lady, they either have a half a day or 3/4 of a day, because a mother cow produces more milk, more beast, and the calves need only 2 liters, so therefore they take the cows away. Also, she mentioned that when they leave the calves in the kettle, then the calves will learn to just suck on the udders of the cow, and when they are back into the regular group, when all the moms have had their calves, and then they might drink from that. They have to learn how to drink out of a regular bowl, and then they do get milk, and then once they're not at a certain age to drink milk, because then they don't have the beast, but like regular milk, then they go switch to grass. How does the mother cow sound during and after their babies have been taken away? How long does this take? And she actually said that it's not that bad. They're not calling each other from one room to another. She didn't go into detail too much, but that's what she said. So yeah, I've seen a couple of videos on this and I've seen it differently, but she did say like some mother cows are not being a typical mother cow. Like some animals in nature don't take care of their babies as well as some others do. So it depends per cow. How do you take care of the calf? What is enough food? What does it consist of? And where do you get it? So as I mentioned, the beast is what they get for the first 48 hours. And it consists of minerals and antistoffe. Once the mother cow is becoming like dry, so they don't produce milk as much, then then they are ready to eat like the regular food, like the grass. How often is there pus or blood inside the milk? The blood sometimes is visible in the beast, but not constantly. And otherwise, if there's pus or anything else in the milk, then it's separated. Do you milk by hand? No, they don't. How often do they milk the cows with a machine? Twice a day. How long do the lights stay on in the stables? Per 24 hours. Once it's dark, the night lights go on because a cow sleeps 20 minutes a day total. What do the regular cows get to eat? Where do you get that? They get chewing grass with vitamins and minerals. And a milk cow also gets chewing grass, is what she called it, but then with more vitamins and more minerals. And I didn't really ask where she got that from. Does the government subsidize your business, or is there another company? And she said, for the milk that they cannot deliver, they get a little amount. And the milk industry, like where they actually bring their milk, gives a little bit when it comes in. They give their milk to Friesland Campina and they bring it, I cannot read my own handwriting, to the Lutje Winkel. Anywho, they make cheese, as already mentioned. Do you care about your animals? In which way, and how can a customer notice that? And her answer was, when you're taking good care of the animal, that animals will take care, good care of you. So basically, when you put a lot of energy and effort into your animal, they will give better prestate? No, that's not a word in English. They will work better, but not work better. They will produce better. They will, if you put in the effort, then they will put in the effort too, basically. And she decided to, alongside her husband, obviously, to also do the hugging cows activity, just to show the people in the environment, or like the people of the Netherlands, what they do. And some people have misconceptions, like for example, when we went inside the stable, she had one stick with her and she said, don't get scared, I just have this stick because there's one jealous cow, and if I don't have the stick, he'll just come and nudge you the entire time. If I do have the stick, the cow knows, oh, never mind, I shouldn't be bothered, I'll just walk around. And I'm not sure what cow she mentioned, or what cow she meant, because I didn't see any cows that were, like, all up in her business. There was one cow near my mom, though, they were kind of, she was kind of peeking. But yeah, those were the questions, and those were the answers. And by now, you have seen the video, you have seen the footage, you have heard the answers. Thank you so much for watching up until this point. I am really grateful that I got to experience this. However, I am happy that I chose to eat the way I do and to not give my money to companies that do things that I don't necessarily think is a good thing. And I'm not saying that Elsa and her husband do things that is like per definition wrong. In my eyes, it's just something that I don't want to do and I don't think the world needs to do. However, everyone believes different things and everyone lives different lifestyles and everyone owns their or earns their money differently, and I respect that people differ in that, and I should respect it. I shouldn't try to push any certain lifestyles upon people. Like, do you? Everyone do you. However, I don't think there's anything wrong with getting informed and being able to explain why you live or eat a certain way. I am happy that I went, but as I already kind of mentioned, like, seeing a calf like that, that's sad. And if a lot of women were to be impregnated by hand and have their baby stolen, and then after 2.5 years not being able to recognize your own baby, but then being pregnant again maybe 2.5 more times, you know, and to be put up on the machine just so non-humans can be fed your own milk product. I don't know, I'm literally putting it now in a way that some of you have probably been bombarded with. I don't ever want to be someone that's pushing something down your throat, but, you know, it's just good to ask questions. Also, when something has become a habit. And these animals, like, they're so cute. I've really learned that cows explore the world with their tongue. Like, I don't know, cows are really cute. I love animals. I really love animals. They're beautiful. Okay. I'm just gonna end the video here because I can talk about this for forever, but then this video is gonna be a lot longer. Thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you in another video. Leave a thumbs up if you liked it. Leave a comment below if you want to chat, and I am getting a call. Bye bye.